Three, two, one, hello.
At last, Colonel.
Oh, man, that was tough.
What have you done this week? Have you not paid your Telstra bill? Because we have had the most technological...
It's Optus. It's Optus. Wow. The okay. Two big failures of Optus this year, soccer and guitar Colonel
it's
live.
A scandal. It's truly scandalous because we have a lot of people hanging out waiting who are not waiting for us. This is going to be the loneliest Facebook Live this morning because
everyone,
the incredibly patient online fans have probably given up on us. So we apologise.
Very sorry, folks.
We're here and we had a great show planned, which is going to be the short version.
A summarised version. It's like when you go to a nice restaurant and you see a nice meal. And you're like, oh, I've got to order that. And then you order that, and 2 hours later, they're like, I'm so sorry, sir. I don't know why I'm putting on a European accent, but, you know, oh, we didn't make it, and we're running out of time. We're very busy. Sorry, folks, if you've tuned in a bit late. We're a bit late. A little bit of technological trouble, but we're all good. How are you, Nigel?
I'm very good.
You have a little bit of a cold.
Last week it was a hangover and a jet lag and a gig. This week it's just a plain, boring head cold.
Oh.
But it's sunny outside and winter's looking up, man. We're in good shape.
That's rock and roll. I should refer to you as... let me put on a voice for this. And there's no candle burning, unfortunately.
Yeah, that's right. We've burned the candle. That's the result
that's
of
our
us
candle.
Stressing over getting the technology going.
Candle's done. The legend of Nigel Dalton.
The league end.
I had a friend of mine come in this week and I said, hey, buddy, what are you doing? I'm working at this company. And I said, oh, I know someone that works there. He's like, man, I saw him and I went up and said, hey, what are you doing here? Are you the star of Shootin' the Strings? It's like, and Nigel does have another job.
Yeah, here I'm just the comedy sidekick. There I've got a little more authority in life. But
a little more power.
You know, as with so many people in life, you have your craft and you have your passion.
Yes.
And guitars are my passion.
Now, so Nigel, can I get you to just move your mic just a fraction there? It's just I can hear it brushing up against your
okay, we're gonna give it a go on the t-shirt. It's risky.
I think if it points down a bit, that's okay. I think that's good.
I'd be very still. That's just the last of our technical issues for today.
That's all right, we're good.
You've chosen a very technical guitar there this morning.
I have I've got a PRS. I just wanted something simple for myself.
Yeah,
and I get all these requests and it's like, Colonel, just show us some cheap gear that we can go and afford ourselves. And I'm like,
no,
forget it,
that's the wrong show.
This is a PRS hollow body.
I've never seen one.
How about that? Hollow 2.
Yeah,
how about that? And
how hollow is it? Is it
totally hollow?
Oh wow,
hello Nigel. It's totally hollow. So
gigantic humbucker pickups on it.
Ooh.
Trademark PRS flying bird along the fretboard.
Yes.
And got a very special trick at the back though. It's got a piezo pickup.
It does. I'm not really an expert on all that sort of stuff, but I guess that gives you an acoustic-y sort of property to the guitar. So if you want to do that sort of thing. But I mean, man, this just, it plays like butter. Whoops. Sounding like Stairway.
Uh-oh. Oh, no Stairway. Rule number one of the guitar, Colonel, no Stairway. Rule number two, no Master of Puppets.
No. Oh! That's the 60s version of Master of Puppets, the spy version. And what are you on, Sir Nigel?
I fretted long and hard over what to choose from this selection this morning because you've had a number of new, beautiful guitars come in.
We have. We've been smashed.
And in the end, I just went for this because it's a beautiful guitar to look at. It is a Fender Stratocaster. It is the well-known shape. It's new, isn't it? Because it's mint.
That's basically, condition. That's a 2017. That's a 57 reissue.
Yeah.
They still make them in Japan. That's a Japanese one. It's called a Japanese exclusive model. It's got the Hendrix Woodstock Olympic white color.
Yeah.
I think that's what they call it.
Yeah.
And Yeah, man, it's got a bit of meat to the neck there. Not too bad.
It has. I like a man with big hands needs that kind of thing. And absolutely. It's sounding very good. So, yeah, plenty of bass. That's what I like.
Yeah.
Quiet on this little position in between the one and the three.
Yes.
Perfect studio guitar, really.
It's absolutely cool.
Looks handsome, too. Shows up my Norton t-shirt I bought in London.
Yes, lovely. Well, I've chosen reggae, which
I'm thrilled about.
Yes.
Partly not, because it's so hard to play, and it's going to be a debacle.
Well,
but partly because it's...
I don't know about that.
I don't know if you know, there was a pivotal moment when I was in year 11 at school in New Zealand.
Tell me about this.
1979, this is yes. The arrival of the Honourable Bob Marley in New Zealand. Now, always a kind of tie-up between Maori culture and the whole Jamaican kind of vibe. We won't, you know, figure out why, but the rhythms yes. and those kind of things. So New Zealand now has a massive Pacifica reggae dub roots
movement.
It's a huge part of everyone's musical language. 1979, it's a bunch of white boys thrashing their guitars in new wave at best and punk at worst.
Good on or your Stairway. White boys. Stairway, yeah.
And now you go to New Zealand, you're likely as much to hear a really solid reggae sound coming out. So many
and
bands.
You're tracing that back.
To 1979, to... one concert, Mount Smart in Auckland. And 25,000 people. I wish I was there. I can't lie. I wasn't there. I was in year 11. What was
that? I used to work with someone who went to that. He tells me this famous story. I don't know if it's true. Maybe if you can write it up. Or if you were there. Yeah. You were there at the Bob Marley New Zealand gig, 79. But he said, I was right up the front. And he had barrels of marijuana burning.
On the stage.
Now, I don't know if that's true. Maybe, and that would be maybe a waste of the marijuana. Unless there
is,
like
there is pipes. There is film footage because a guy, Dylan Tate, who was a very big music journalist, he did a short documentary on it. And pardon my voice.
That's right.
Visiting a local marae, which is the Maori sacred place. Yes. And it's an amazing documentary just to watch that meeting of the cultures. And
that's cool.
All right. We need to turn my microphone down.
If you have a solution for Sir Nigel's...
I think the solution is I stop talking, Colonel, and you start teaching me how to play some reggae so I can be a proper New Zealander.
He's got a bit of a cold. It's either that or the AIDS is playing up again. I don't know. It's one or the other.
No idea.
But let's start with Jammin.
Jammin, fantastic.
And please bring in some hot lemon tea. Or something for Nigel today, if you could. That would be cool.
See if I can access my 1979 New Zealand roots. And
that'd be cool.
You know, today we have Fat Freddy's Drop, Betcha Doop, Catch a Fire, which was named after one of his albums.
I saw Super Groove.
Do you know
Super Groove?
Yeah, totally.
I saw them years ago, so they were kind of cool. And there was a little bit of that in there. But, okay, we're going to have a look at Jammin' by Bob Marley. Bob Marley is a reggae king, let's face it. There's no mucking about.
No,
I'm going to start with a B minor.
Nothing ironic about two foreign white guys playing this either. But
I reckon maybe go clean, Sir Nigel. And we're going to play, it's a minor. The other white meat. Okay, so the chords are B minor, E7, G major, F sharp minor. But I'm going to play my B minor here, and I'm going to go to an E7 right here. Because really, all I'm doing, I'm keeping, when I play my B minor, I'm basically keeping my middle finger here. Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm just going to move these two fingers over. And so here's a D7 shape.
I see.
And I'm going to be tricky. I'm going to just slide that D7 shape up too. Yeah. And then I'm going to go to it. Yeah, that's it.
I'm going to do that again because my brain is... Well, you've got to get your...
You don't necessarily have to move it. I wouldn't play that note. You can choose with your right hand. Maybe you'll play five strings, play four strings. Yeah. Then a G in a bar chord shape. You don't have to do that, of course. To an F sharp minor. So So we've got one, two, three, four. That's basically how the song starts, okay? But once he gets into singing it, the band kind of switches, or the rhythm kind of switches to that reggae rhythm.
Right.
Now, reggae rhythm is on the two and the four, okay? It's one, two, three, four. And that's the trick to reggae. You can make anything reggae as long as you switch that beat to the two, the four.
Interesting to watch the video of that 79 concert, and you'll actually see the guitarists, they're just keeping it so simple. They are literally just going 2-4.
I'll use
two,
a music term
four.
That Neil Bolan likes to use all the time
because
he's a musician.
Mixolydian bombo-plastic.
It's called in the pocket. Hey man, I'm in the pocket.
Ooh.
It's a jazz term. I've got my jazz hat on. We've got some people on today. Well, I will say hello to you all. Michael Ray. Michael Ray's been to everything. I went to Horton Pavilion Bob Marley gig. There was a mass of sacred herb burning there.
Yes.
Man, you watch out. Okay, let's do it.
Yeah, let's give it a go.
I better show you the rest of the song.
Oh, okay. I was really hoping that was it, actually, because we've already used my four chords up.
So it starts... So then it's the same, basically, but instead of going straight to the G, he'll go B minor, da-da-da-da, E7, back to B minor, to E7, right? G. I wanna jam it with you. And then just normal. We're jamming. And that's really the only change at the beginning there. The only other thing is, da da. It goes to B minor to E minor.
Okay, that's not too hard. I know where the E is.
Yeah.
It's not sounding perfectly.
Move those. Yes. Or a suspended will work. And then back to the B minor. Does this little trick.
I think the whole audience would be interested in that trick.
Okay. B minor. And I'm just sliding off the guitar. And then I cut the sound. I like that.
Well, that's a
I
nice
could do
one.
That all day. I could do that sort of shenanigans all day. Man, our stream looks a bit jerky today, but we'll keep going with it.
Yeah,
please just pass on some feedback.
That would be par for the course for our this morning.
It's a weird world of technology today. Okay, we're going to play along. We're going to go with it.
Yep.
This is Jammin, Bob Marley.
We're Jammin.
We're Jammin. Here we go with Bob. Back and forth. G.
in Mount Zion. It rules all creation. Here we're with Jammin.
I just said B minor. Jammin.
I want to jam it with you.
Sorry, just double down there.
We're jammin.
You should see my upload speed. It's terrible, folks.
Well, the ghost of Bob will help us out here, I think, because I think it's music for everyone. I think the, you know, that whole Rastafarian, the whole religion took off in New Zealand, a very culturally aligned piece and giant amounts of weed. But we won't mention that. And no, I love it. Wow, this is good. This is nice Saturday morning hanging.
It's hanging. You know, their whole... religion, and now I'm just making a sweeping statement.
Sure.
I'm just going to do I'm going to be out there.
We're broadcasters, and in Australia, that's allowed.
Well, it's allowed in some spots. It's allowed here.
There are no standards. And I meant to ask you, is Channel 9 buying the Guitar Colonel show on Saturday morning as well? Because they seem to be buying everything else at the moment.
Well, I...
No,
but I'm interested. I mean, I'm not one of these people that will sit here and say, you know what, Nigel, I'm going to keep it independent. No, I would sell out tomorrow.
Yep.
But, and I'm going to be hosting the Logies in 2020. I guarantee you that.
Need to ramp up, really. But
I need to ramp up big time. You know, jar. Okay. And I don't mean...
Sure.
I don't mean a jar of peanut butter. No. I mean jar, the reggae religious figure.
Sure, yeah.
Isn't he... Now, you will know this, Nigel, I guess.
Maybe.
Isn't he the king, or was the king of Ethiopia at one point?
Haile Selassie. Yeah, so the kind of tribes of Israel immigrating to the world. This is kind of the origins of the beliefs. And look, it's as solid as any other crazy-ass religion.
Man.
At least in his case, he didn't discover a golden tablet and go to Salt Lake City.
Jesus, Mormons.
Well, no, not Jesus in that case.
Look, you know...
Book of Mormon.
If you want to get into religion, folks, get into something solid like Scientology or just something decent.
With a scientific base to it.
With a scientific base, absolutely. Yeah. That's Jammin' by Bob Marley. That's a killer.
Yeah.
How about... sadly, he was gunned down in his prime, Peter Tosh.
Superb. Much under-recognised. One of the Wailers. Knowing a bit of history here. So, you know, you had Bob Marley and the Wailers.
I didn't even know that. Isn't that terrible?
They split, 74, done. You know, so, and of course, all the lovely date lineups here. So they, 63.
Yeah.
This was Marley when picking up music and getting together with the gang. Mm. Peter Tosh taught all the kids around him to play.
Wow.
Self-taught, guitarist and keyboarder. He taught the others to play and they, you know, and of course, Bob exploded.
Right.
So you had the Wailers, they split. Tosh had his own career. Didn't last that long, unfortunately. Wasn't a healthy man. Dead, in fact, by the 1980s. And Marley went on.
Killed by his own AK-47 guitar.
And what's lovely about that, it was a Strat.
That's cool. Killed by Strat.
Yeah.
Nothing wrong with that.
So an American guy gave it to him. It was a modified Stratocaster. Have a look on the internet. In the shape of an AK-47. And he played it everywhere as a, you know, like an, it was an anti-gun. It was a peace message. It was, this is my weapon. You know, love is my weapon. So I don't see one of those out on the shelves at the Guitar Kernel, by the way.
You do see a lot of love and a lot of weapons here, though. So I'm liking that. Well, let's have a look at the only, I mean, this is sad of me, but the main Peter Tosh song that I know is Don't Look Back with Mick Jagger.
That was pivotal for him. That was, in terms of becoming into the mainstream understanding. I don't know if you've seen the video of it. I mean, Jagger's 25 or something. He's just, he looks like an elf.
I have to look it up. I don't know if I have ever seen that that video.
But, no.
Speaking of video, if you are watching us and we're a little bit laggy on the stream, don't worry, because I record it all and we load it to YouTube and iTunes. And
okay, I swear that's not me.
What is that?
It's a phone.
Oh,
it's your phone.
Phone. Oh. We're closed, if you're calling.
It's the CIA going, what is that music you're playing?
It's Optus calling to apologise for their sad...
Actually, doesn't it say Trumbull? Malcolm Trumbull?
Malcolm Trumbull's calling. Oh, my goodness. So you should, sir, you terrible man. But
So what
it'll be loaded up later, guys, so you can check it out in full HD. Let's have a look at it.
Let's do
We're going to start with a C. Sorry about
that. Okay, it's a proper C.
Proper C. Yeah.
Still scratching.
It's a bit scratchy. It's a little scratchy. Oh, can you pin it on? Can you pin it on the Norton?
Upside down. I'm just going to have to pin it right. Maybe we'll go here.
On the nipple.
On the N.
Oh, yeah. There we go. Hey, I like that. So it's... So that's a C. We're going clean to F. Then F, C, up to a high F, 8, C, again, G. So it's dun 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 dun. That is it again. So if you just put your hand in mine, A minor.
Yes.
Yes. We're gonna see all our troubles behind. D. We're gonna walk and don't look back. Don't look back. And walk and don't look back. That's my Mick Jagger. Then. Easy.
So simple in the chord structure, but
yes.
I'm going to have to say I'm struggling a little with the rhythms, which is the genius of reggae. So why don't we just play along so that my ineptitude can be disguised by the brilliance of Peter Tosh and yourself.
All right, let's do it. Guys, sorry if I haven't liked your comments. We're going to play along. I'm doing it now.
It's been a tense morning for technology. We are very thankful you all turned up and came and gave us some encouragement.
My goodness.
We were ready.
Technology.
What time does the pub across the road open? Because we were ready to decamp and just drown our sorrows in craft beer.
Well, I'll tell you what, talking of craft beer, well, we'll talk about it when we come back, but we've got a craft beer show coming up this afternoon with Alan.
Nice.
Who likes a beer.
He is a connoisseur of the beer.
Oh my God. Is he coming back to your team? Is that top secret?
I should be so lucky. We'll be right back. And the way I was always getting caught out was that I'm so used to, when a chord changes, using the one on the chord as a really big playing signal that I've changed chord.
Yeah.
So to have to go from changed chord, nothing.
On the two.
Yeah, and then the two comes in is really, that's Alzheimer's avoided right there.
Tech term for you today, syncopated rhythm. Syncopated rhythm, that's what it is, right? Yeah, you know, the other trick is they tend to play, they don't use the bass a lot because the bass is doing the bass. Right?
Yeah.
If that actually makes a lot of sense, doesn't it? So if I'm going, G to C.
They're probably not using a lot of this either. They're doing a lot of that. It's finger picking.
So I'm on that 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. The 2 and the 4, right?
Yeah.
But if I really want to make it sound reggae, I'd probably play a G in a in an F shape and then the C.
Oh, so hard. I think it's a really good exercise for learners to have to deal with.
Just such a simple change, G to C, but, you know, playing on that 2 and the 4 and then singing Mick Jagger. Sorry, just making myself laugh with some Mick Jagger. Have we got time for one more?
I reckon we can slide another one in for sure.
Man, should I pull out the big guns and go for Is This Love by Bob Marley? Can we do it?
I think so.
I'll do the riff. I'll show you the chords.
Okay, sounds good.
It's a bit tricky. Let's see who's on really quick. Brett Duxbury. Brent Duxbury. Thanks, guys. I'll be having a crack at that in rehearsal today. Hey, nice. Cunningly Angus. That's a mouthful. Okay, so I'm just going to play the riff and we'll go through it once. But the chords are F sharp minor to a D. Yeah. Okay, so it's... So then there's an A, so it's F sharp minor, D, A, E. Yeah.
Oh, I love it.
That's cool, isn't it? Okay.
That's
so
cool.
He varies that a little bit.
Right.
Right? So when he first starts singing, he'll just do it for two. One, two, one.
One on the A, one on the E on the way back down.
And then when he comes back, he's on there for four. Which would be about there. So yeah, so it's half.
Yeah,
and then
so two beats on the A and two beats on the E on the way back down again.
I'll lead you through. The only other change there is... when he starts
C-sharp?
Talking, when he starts getting wasted minor. And talking about Zion. Yeah, C-sharp minor.
Sad notes, those.
And then, okay. And then it's B. Now, you don't have to play this. You can just go straight to a D major 7 if you want to. Make sure you put that D open. And I'll do the change, which is... Da, 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 da,
da, da. It's nice, but I'm not going to get it for sure.
Oh. And then back to the C sharp minor. So the main thing you need to remember to make definitely minor for this. B minor. F sharp minor. E. D. C sharp minor. C sharp. B minor. And then back to the same. I think he makes it quick. Okay.
Right.
This is, I don't expect you to nail this straight away because this is hard, folks. This is actually a very hard song to play. Without doubt.
These are all amazing rhythms.
That's, incredible.
That's
incredible.
The cool thing.
So we're going to, a 1 minute lesson in Is This Love by Bob Marley. It's not enough, but.
Who knows?
Who knows? Maybe you picked
it. It's inspiration.
It's inspirational. Should we do it?
It would be great to
give it a go.
It would be great to have a bass player and a drummer to help us along.
You're like someone that I could say, hey, get in and drive that car as fast as you can around track. You're like, yeah, I'll do it.
Okay.
It's unbelievable. I like
which
that. Is,
which
it's
one
amazing.
Of these pedals is it? Was it left and right or right and left?
We're going to give it a go, folks. Here we go. Oh, is this love? Is this love? Is this love?
I'm going to rely on that. Bob Marley started out with a Strat very like this, and then he went to Gibbon Gibson.
Oh man, he went Les Paul Special. There is a signature Les Paul Special. How about that? It says our stream health is good, so I hope it's coming through.
It's
got
P90s, isn't it?
It does have P90s. Special,
yeah. It's missing from my list of guitars I own.
Mm. We get them occasionally, but you know, here we go, folks. I'll just play that. Speaking of finished, Sir Nigel has come in.
I know.
From his deathbed.
I got the severe case of a man flu. No. So, small coincidence.
Yes.
But seen the video for that song?
I have.
It's set in a little England. School. Yeah. Which suburb is it filmed in London, where I was. But.
Knightsbridge.
10 days ago. No, Islington.
It's where?
Filmed in Islington.
Right, wow. How about that? That's amazing.
And,
I didn't know that.
So, Islington, what a hot bit of music.
He fled Jamaica because he'd been shot or something? Is that the story?
No, I'm not really sure how he ended up there, but he ended up shooting the video in this, it's a wonderful multicultural neighborhood. So that was down the left-hand side.
Right.
And, you know, at the right-hand side, there was, we were staying with James and Miriam at, right next to the studio where you had New Order, Floyd the Wall. A suburb for music. You've got Floyd at that end and New Order. And at this end, you've got Bob Marley recording.
Wow.
What a time to be alive.
Incredible, incredible. I think that move to England influenced quite a few bands like The Police and different things. There's Reggae and The Clash, and because he kind of went over in that late 70s period there. And brought his Reggae.
I'm very glad he did. He was the name of the documentary on the New Zealand tour is Came a Long Way.
Right.
Which is his opening line at the concert, go, I come a long way, man.
Wow.
And he did. And what an ambassador for music.
Amazing.
And a genre in peace and love.
I absolutely love him. I love the song. I love you too, Sir Nigel. We got to go, guys. I have a lesson on, but this will be on YouTube. Please subscribe to us. We need more subscribers.
Yeah.
They've changed the rules, and now that I don't have 1,000 subscribers, you think I would? But I don't.
And if you fancy a beautifully simple to play and aesthetically perfect guitar, this white Stratocaster made in Japan is the answer. If you fancy something that's extraordinary and
if you
exotic,
want the same description that Nigel just gave and you have more money, that's the facts. It's this one.
But you're not going to see a hollow body PRS every day. So come in and play it. It's astonishing.
Use it today. It is astonishing. Thanks, guys. We're out of here. Ciao.
Thank you. See you later.
Oh, I'll be back this afternoon.